Ladies and gentlemen, a pleasant, good late afternoon. Welcome to the Lewis Sports Network. Before we get started, make sure to hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, make sure those post notifications are turned on, make sure you share it on your social media platforms. Truly appreciate it. Hope everybody is having a wonderful Tuesday afternoon. Peace and blessings, everybody. Thank you for always taking the time to always watch my videos, liking them, sharing them, and to my new subscribers who continue to subscribe to channels and let others know, man. Appreciate that. Now, on to the video. While I was thinking about WrestleMania 21, something really dawned on me when I thought about the match of the night. And I'm going to make a video on WrestleMania 21, but I wanted to focus on this Hall of Famer who wrestled that night, and he wrestled another future Hall of Famer. So basically, it was two future Hall of Famers in this five-star classic. And it was the match of the night. And the match I'm talking about is Kurt Angle against Shawn Michaels. But I don't want to focus on Shawn Michaels. I want to focus on Kurt Angle. And here's why. It's crazy that Kurt, for such a short time period in his WWE career, and I look at his WrestleManias, because we always look at Kurt's career and he did so much in so little time, you know, in the WWF/WWE business. We don't even really talk about the quality of work that Kurt Angle actually did in his WrestleManias when he was there. And it's crazy because he was not there long enough, so it doesn't get talked about. But now that I thought about it, I look back, because his first WrestleMania was, what, back in 2000? And if you look at his, he competed in seven WrestleManias. But check this out. In 2000, he was the European and Intercontinental Champion, and he arguably had probably the greatest rookie year probably ever for a superstar in WWE history. You could even, it's up there definitely in wrestling history. But in that match, he was the European and Intercontinental Champion, and he went up against Chris Jericho and Chris Benoit. Chris Benoit ended up being Intercontinental Champion, and then Jericho ended up being the European Champion. But that match was actually really good. It was actually one of my favorite matches of the 2000s. And it's an underrated match that I think should get a little more recognition. It was really that good. I mean, you had an Olympic gold medalist and a grappler and a technician in mat wrestling, in amateur wrestling, going up against the two of the best technical wrestlers ever in Chris Jericho and Chris Benoit. And Chris Jericho with the ability to, you know, be a high flyer and have also the technical ability to put on a nice little wrestling match. All three of those guys were very good technicians in the ring and can wrestle, and they had great chemistry. And it's one of the more underrated matches that honestly doesn't even really get talked about enough. But I thought that match was good, obviously along with the triangle ladder match between the Hardys, Edge and Christian, and the Dudleys. I mean, that match was the show of the night. That match stole the show. But I think if you were looking for another match, it was definitely Jericho, Angle, and Benoit in 2000. Now we go to the 2001. Kurt Angle has already became the WWF champion in 2000. He won the King of the Ring also. As I mentioned, that he had arguably the greatest rookie year, you know, in WWE history. And like I said, up there in wrestling history, he faces Chris Benoit. And they proceed to have a classic WrestleMania match at WrestleMania 17. And WrestleMania 17 is regarded by most as arguably the greatest WrestleMania of all time. Everybody has their opinions, but doing the poll, it's regarded as the greatest WrestleMania of all time when you look at the card. But anyway, I saw the match between Angle and Benoit, and that match was so good. So good. You're talking about two wrestlers, two technicians, who were able to add physicality to their wrestling abilities, and it made the match entertaining and competitive. Another underrated match, and it's one of the greatest WrestleMania matches of all time that doesn't get also its just due. And I recommend you watch not only the Jericho Angle Benoit match, but you should watch the one-on-one match between Kurt and Chris Benoit. So that's that. Then you have 2002, Kurt Angle against Kane. And I thought that their feud, their buildup, it's crazy because I first thought, you know, Kurt and Kane, it kind of doesn't make sense when at first they put the storyline together. And then I look back on it, they had, I think the channel was TH14, and it showed the story of Kurt Angle versus Kane. And I had totally forgot about that storyline. But then when I look back, I said, it was some pretty entertaining stuff. And while the match isn't fondly remembered due to because of what happened with Rock and Hogan, you know, pretty much stealing the show, and that's what most wrestling fans talk about, Kurt Angle and Kane actually had a really good match too. And another underrated gem of Kurt Angle, and it's like, damn, he's been part of three really good WrestleMania matches up to that point in 2002. I was like, okay. So now we go to 2003. By this point, Kurt had already been a three-time WWE champion. He had a classic match with Chris Benoit at the Royal Rumble, and that's another match that I think that you should watch. And I know what Chris Benoit obviously became, and you know, it's unfortunate with what he's obviously connected to and how the WWE has tried to erase him from memory. But going back though, watch that match between Kurt and Chris Benoit. You will blow the roof away. It shows you the great chemistry that both men had, and they made the technical matches seem so fun, and the spots that they always would do, it would have you jumping out of your chair, and it, you know, you would always have tense moments as to who would win back and forth. And they were so physical with each other, but they had such great chemistry. And it was for the WWE Championship because Kurt was the champion at the time. But I'm telling you, that match was so good. Another match that doesn't get mentioned enough, and I definitely recommend you guys go check that out. But then he was in a feud with Brock Lesnar. Very good buildup. Have a classic match at WrestleMania. Doesn't get talked about. It gets talked about, but not nearly as enough. I remember Kurt was going into that match. He ended up injuring his neck and had to get neck surgery. But it was also because of the fact that the focus was on Rock and Austin and then Hogan and Vince. So you have four of the biggest names ever. They're going to pretty much draw the attention. But Kurt and Lesnar was unbelievable. That was a really nice classic wrestling match, and it's one of the greatest matches, WrestleMania matches of all time. I recommend watching that too. It was good. I know the crowd was spent by what they had watched in the last two matches, but again, another good match. Another really good match. Then we go to 2004. Now at this point, Kurt Angle is starting to show flashes of kind of becoming a more vicious, you know, of a more vicious heel. I mean, he had first showed it a little bit in 2001 and in 2002, but he was still kind of a comedic heel in a sense. But in 2004, he was really beginning to show it with what happened when he had got into a nice little rivalry with Eddie Guerrero. And then they ended up putting a classic WWE Championship match at WrestleMania. And it was great because you got to see two technical wrestlers definitely go at it. Eddie was the champion at the time. He just came off defeating Brock Lesnar at the No Way Out pay-per-view in San Francisco, California. And it was such an emotional ride. And to see Eddie get hit the frog splash on Lesnar and get the win after the interference at Goldberg, it was incredible. It was incredible that we were going to see Kurt against Eddie. And they put on such a classic match. It's another underrated gem of Kurt Angle. And I'm just saying to myself, damn. And I'm like looking back on it, it's crazy that this doesn't even really get mentioned out of Kurt, but it was like, damn, four good WrestleMania matches in a row? I was like, there's no way Kurt Angle could get better than this. And Eddie ends up winning that night, but it was still a classic. And I remember how it happened. Eddie loosened up his boot to try to pretty much trick Kurt just because he thought, you know, his ankle was like, you know, sore and lump after getting put in the ankle lock. But now we go to 2005. In 2005, this was where Kurt was really becoming the wrestling machine now. He goes up against Shawn Michaels, and everybody knows there's a reason why Shawn Michaels is called Mr. WrestleMania, ladies and gentlemen. Shawn Michaels is in the Royal Rumble. Kurt's at the Royal Rumble at the same time. Shawn Michaels super kicks him out of the Rumble. Kurt goes berserk. Probably the most berserk I had ever seen Kurt go berserk, probably other than that time that he went nuts on Scotty Too Hotty, and like it really legit looked like he like broke his ankle back four years ago. And that was when Kurt had lost the WWE Championship to The Rock. But going back and looking at that buildup with Shawn and Kurt, and you can see the viciousness in Kurt Angle, like little by little. Like it was just like building and building. And then you go to WrestleMania, Kurt and Shawn had never wrestled together, and they put on a five-star classic that I still watch anytime I get the chance to watch those two go to battle. You're talking about Shawn Michaels, who was a high flyer and had evolved his technical abilities and was putting on some of the best matches in his career in his second run with the company, and was a great, was he was an amazing storyteller. Like, Shawn was really good in the 90s, but he was an amazing storyteller and was putting guys over in the 2000s. You know, and he put Kurt over in this match. And, you know, Shawn, every time it's WrestleMania season, Shawn's juices get, like, competitive. He gets too competitive at all. Sorry, that's Bad Bunny right there in the background. Always happens when it interferes anytime a Muppet is. But anyway, Shawn and Kurt put on a classic match. You can see Kurt getting vicious, and it was a lot. It was mostly about who was the best wrestling performer of this generation. And the meaning behind the storyline was that Kurt was upset that when he won the gold medal and representing the Olympic Games in Atlanta, all the talk was about Shawn Michaels and what he did in the Iron Man match with Bret the Hitman Hart. And so it was an insult to Kurt, and he was saying, and it was an insult to what he stands for in the industry, you know, and that's what that was all about. And then what's crazy about it is Kurt has three classic matches with Shawn that year. It started off at WrestleMania with their classic five-star classic, an incredible match that I recommend you watch. And then at Vengeance in 2005, Kurt and Shawn Michaels 2, you could argue was probably even better than their WrestleMania match. It's crazy to say, but you can argue that their Vengeance match was better than their WrestleMania match. And then they had a great Iron Man match following that too for 30 minutes. It just showed you the great chemistry that Shawn and Kurt had, and they had not, to that point, they never really wrestled. That's how good Kurt's 2005 was. And I'm like saying to myself, damn, Kurt has put on five good WrestleMania matches. And then 2006, Kurt Angle becomes the World Heavyweight Champion after Batista ends up tearing his triceps. He has a triceps injury. And Kurt is in the storyline with Rey Mysterio, who had just won the Royal Rumble. By the way, and let me just say this. I know Rey was not the first number two entrant to win the Royal Rumble. That was Vince McMahon. But the reason that I put Rey's in more high regard is that when Vince was the number two entrant in the 99 Rumble, he had the corporation involved, and also he was out of the ring at the time that he was feuding with Austin, you know, when they were competing in the Rumble match. And Vince, and the reason that the reason that Austin got eliminated was because The Rock came and interfered in the match, and Vince ended up winning. But I'm saying, in terms of Rey never left the ring. And by that point, he was in the Rumble match longer than anybody in his. He lasted 62 minutes. Just over 62 minutes in the Rumble match to win. And look who were the last two opponents he eliminated. Randy Orton was the number 30 entrant. He eliminated him in a beautiful fashion. And shout out to Randy for selling that Hurricane Rana off the top rope. And then obviously with Triple H. I mean, you're talking about Rey Mysterio gets to go over those two guys. Incredible feat. And so yeah, Kurt's in the storyline with Randy Orton and Rey Mysterio for the World Heavyweight Championship. It was really good. I love the build-up to WrestleMania. But fast forward, it's a shame. Those three had great chemistry, and the match was really, really, really good. The only problem was they only wrestled for 9 minutes. That's what sucked. And it's crazy. And I know that they were trying to build John Cena, you know, when he was going up against Triple H. But the crazy part was that world title match was, even to me, was better than John Cena and Triple H. See, what made John Cena and Triple H good was I felt that the crowd played a huge factor in that match. Made it very nice and compelling, but it was good. Don't get me wrong. Like, I enjoyed Cena and Triple H. It was good. And I liked the storytelling in the match where, you know, Cena was the underdog, despite the fact that he was the champion. It's like you won a championship, but you're a fluke. And it's like, now, can you really prove it, like, when it really matters the most against a 10-time champion? So it was like, you know, the odds were just against John Cena, and he overcame the odds. So it was good storytelling. But I just felt, from an in-ring work perspective, I felt that Orton-Mysterio angle match was better. I just hate the fact that they only got 9 minutes, and it's a damn shame. It's the reason why it doesn't get talked about enough. But I really wish that match got more airtime, because I was really entertained and it was only 9 minutes. And the crowning moment was Ray winning the title, but I felt that it should have got more airtime. So when you look back at it, ladies and gentlemen, and the reason I'm going 15 minutes long is because it's crazy that Kurt Angle had seven really good WrestleMania matches. And what sucks is the 2006 one was his shortest. But each one of the matches that he had at WrestleMania was pretty awesome. And I'm mentioning this now because I wish more people would recognize, man, that Kurt, when the lights were on bright, even on the biggest stage, Kurt could put on a really good show. And it doesn't get mentioned enough. And Kurt Angle, man, if you're listening, I just want to tell you, man, that I just feel like what you've done for the business is incredible. And I think that you've gotten your flowers, but I feel like you deserve a lot more because your Kurt Angle to me is the definition of quality in a short time. His quality is better than his quantity when it comes to his WWE career. He did so much in so little time. And it's crazy. His legacy could have been even bigger, you know, had he not had his health issues, and then obviously had issues with the front office and with Vince McMahon back in 06. But anyway, be it as it may, ladies and gentlemen, there's your boy with another one, Lewis. Let me know what you guys think of the video with Kurt Angle and, you know, your opinion on the fact that he's performed well in WrestleMania, has had some good matches. Let me know what you guys think. Bless up, live, love, love. Thank you guys for watching.